With the price of oil at a record low, the government has moved to shore up our supplies to put the country in a better position during times of crisis. It's a wise move, but not one that's as simple as it may seem.
The global pandemic spotlighted how fragile international supply chains can be as nations fought over scarce medical supplies.
And if we're at the end of a long supply chain with no mandated stocks in Australia for medicines, which is us, then we've got a risk.
It's reignited demands for Australia to end its heavy reliance on imported oil.
We've been running at about 3 weeks of stocks, for example, of diesel now for over a decade. At times it's got as low as 12 days.
The International Energy Agency requires its 30 members to hold 90 days of emergency oil stocks. Australia hasn't met that mark since 2012, currently has 55 days supply and is one of only two non-compliant countries. The government says it's keen to plug this strategic weakness.
There's a whole range of possible disruptions to the supply of fuel.
And with oil prices at an historic low,
this is a unique opportunity to begin building a fuel reserve.
The government's making a down payment of $94 million to buy fuel. The problem is Australia has nowhere to put it, so our emergency oil will be stored in America.
The United States isn't New Zealand. I mean, it's not next door.
You've got to look at the stocks in Australia where you might need them. And having it stuck as oil in the United States doesn't help our domestic fuel security.
But in time, we're exploring opportunities with the industry to establish local storage.
Australia is also winning allies to its call for an international review of the outbreak of COVID-19. Some believe the World Health Organization needs the powers of a weapons inspector to be able to force its way into a country where there's a developing health crisis that will no doubt be staunchly resisted by China. Chris Yeoman, Nine News.